Namu Adi, Dumela It's always a privilege and honor to be in the house of the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Are you all happy this morning? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Can we go straight to the word of the Lord?
Amen.
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 The book of 1 John.
Chapter 1.
And the second book of Corinthians, chapter 5.
Amen.
Amen. We just want to speak about fellowship with God through reconciliation.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
I will start with the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5, taking it from verse 18 and verse 19.
Verse 18 and verse 19. Kumi chao kama kadi chao mudimu e arivuela ncha ole na ka Jesu Kriste aridira ba tanka ba yona puela no yeu. Kagubani ki mudimu e avuela ncha ole fasili ena ka Kriste alisa kubale la batho dikarogo tsa bona mefoko la poelano yeo ke ena a le timilego mo gare ga rena.
Amen. 1 John chapter 1 verse 6 and verse 7. Or let me take it from verse 5. Amen. This then is the message which we have heard of him and declare unto you that God is light,
yes,
and in him is no darkness at all.
Amen.
If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie,
yes,
and do not the truth.
Yeah.
But if we walk in the light, as he is the light, we have fellowship one with another.
Amen.
And the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from all sin.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Re kwele go go yena ye re le anegela go yona ke ye ere go modimo ke sietja go mme mo go yena ga go se ka ba go le swiswi. Ge re 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 ba tee le yena mme ra tloga ra swara tsela ya le swiswi gona ra ketsa ga re dire theretso. Fela ge re tshwere ka tsela ya sietja boka le yena a le wa sietjeng. Gona re ba tee seng sa rena mme madi a Jesu Kriste morwa wa gagwe a re tlhatswa dibitsotlhe.
Dear Heavenly Father, dear God, we come humbly before thy throne of mercy and grace this morning. We thank you, Almighty God, for the opportunity to be gathered together as the believers.
Amen.
Of the message of the hour.
Amen.
Lord, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that thou will please send down at this time your precious Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Dear God, we cannot get anywhere without thy Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Father, we pray that thou will please open up the windows of heaven.
Yes.
And may you please shower thy blessings upon us this morning. We are under the expectation to hear from thee this morning, O God. Father, I pray that thou will please hide me behind the cross.
Yes.
May you please, dear Lord, shut my mouth from saying anything which is not according to the word.
Yes.
And Father, may you speak in your own very special way.
Yes.
My God, I pray that thou will meet the needs of your children.
Yes.
May you speak to the hearts of your children this morning, O God. In the name of the Lord Jesus, may you bless your word.
Amen.
May you break the bread of life,
O
God, and may we be fed.
Amen.
May when we go out of this place, dear Lord,
Amen,
go out being blessed indeed by the Lord.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, may you bless your word, O Father,
Amen,
for thy word is life. In
Amen.
Jesus' mighty name we pray, believing. Amen.
Amen.
May the Lord bless you, saints of God.
Amen.
You may be
seated. Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
Before we get to our message this morning, there is this little quotation I want to share with the saints from the message Satan's Eden. We all know that we are living in the Eden of the devil.
Yes.
We all know that this Eden is controlled by demons.
Right.
From the government itself,
yes,
all the governments of this world are governed and influenced by demons.
Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Now the prophet is saying, there is a God of this world that I preached about last Sunday. And here he is today in deceit. In this that treacherous hour, that tremendous time that we are living, It's the most glorious time of all ages.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Because we are facing the great millennium again.
Amen.
We are facing the Eden again. But right at this age, all the deceit and every tactic, all of them, all, amen.
Amen.
I wish you can write this down. All the deceit and every tactic that the devil has ever used and been able to deceive with, he's gathered it all together. Amen.
Amen.
And reinforced himself. Praise the name of God.
Amen.
We are facing the millennium again. And that is a problem to the devil. And the aim of the devil is that you should not go to the millennium. Praise the name of the Lord. The problem is the millennium. None of us has ever lived 1,000 years. Praise the name of the Lord. Now the devil doesn't want you there.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is why he's using all the tactics and the deceit that you go not in there.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Amen. And he has come down like God. And has put himself in a place of God. Religious. And can quote the scripture. And can tell you the scripture. That is why you must be careful. When a minister is ministering to you, check that minister by the scripture. No matter who that minister is, check that man by the scripture. Because the devil can use, hallelujah, the preacher. Amen. The devil can use the preacher to deceive you. Therefore, use the scripture to check the preacher. Glory to God. Use the scripture to check the preacher. If it's of the word, you take it not. What he's saying. No matter his status, no matter his position, if it's not according to the scripture, it's off.
Amen.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the devil is using his tactics. Amen. The devil is very smart. The devil is very smart. And he's got his ways of doing things. He's been deceiving many great men. From the beginning, he's been deceiving. He is a deceiver. And now, he's gathered everything, put together the tactics that he used in the days of Martin Luther,
hey,
during John Wesley's time. You put them all, the church ages together. He has now brought them together in this church age. Because there are some people in this church age who are supposed to be into the millennium. And now the devil doesn't want you get into the millennium. Because those who go into the millennium are the ones who are not going to be judged. Are the ones who go in the rapture.
Amen.
So we better be careful. We better pull up our socks. We better be ready. We better not sleep. Amen. We better pray and check the scriptures. Check every man according to the scripture. You know, many times we make a mistake. This brother has been a good brother for a long time. And he's been preaching for a long time. And we cannot be able to leave this brother. It doesn't work like
that.
It doesn't work like that. No matter who he is. If it's of the scripture, run away.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is the time to run for your life. Because demons are fighting. The devil is after your soul. You better run for your soul. Run for your life. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Now the prophet is saying, but my main achievement is to preach the gospel.
Yes.
Is to preach the gospel through the church. And do all that I can to bring honor to Jesus Christ.
This
day.
Amen.
While I'm here on earth. What time I have left on earth. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
To preach the gospel.
Amen.
And bring honor to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That is his achievement.
Amen.
That is the desire of the prophet.
Amen.
Not to preach to make money.
Amen.
Hence he was not preaching prosperity gospel.
Amen.
Like what is happening today.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
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 Let's go to the message. Fellowship today. But we better be careful. The devil is not sleeping. Amen. The devil can use any person, young and old. Amen.
Amen.
He can use any preacher, any pastor, any deacon. He's not a respect of a person. If you are living recklessly, you don't preach by inspiration, but by experience.
Amen.
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 Reconciliation.
Puela.
Fellowship with God through reconciliation. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The dove and the crow has got nothing in common. The English proverb says, amen.
Amen.
The birds of the feather flocks together.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The reason they flock together is because they've got certain things in common. Hence they can flock together.
Amen.
And as they flock together, then they fellowship together.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now the crow and the dove. Has got nothing in common.
Amen.
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 Because one can feast from dead carcass or rotten carcass, and the other only live by wheat because it's clean.
Yeah.
But this other one, hallelujah,
he's
a scavenger.
Yeah.
He's a hypocrite. Can eat the salt and eat the salt. Hallelujah. He can eat this side half the day. Feasting on dead bodies. The whole half day.
Yeah.
And then from the afternoon, come the side to feast with the dove.
He's
a hypocrite. He's got such hypocrites.
Yeah.
In the houses of God. During the week, they are feasting upon the things of the world. They are living in the world. They are doing the things of the world. Come Sunday, they come this side to feast this side. You are a hypocrite if you do so.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. Brother Branham says the natural always types the spiritual. Glory to God. Now you know yourself. You know whether you are a crow or you are a dove.
Amen.
But these two has got nothing in common. Now this dove should it try to come this side to eat from this dead carcass leaf. Just one bite,
it will
die.
Yeah.
You know why? Because it's got no guile inside. Hallelujah. It's got nothing to digest the word with. A child of God has got no guile inside. He cannot eat from the world.
Amen.
I mean, if you can eat this side and come this side, then there's something wrong
with
that. Joshua came to a point one day when he was talking to
Israel.
He said, you better make up your mind. You cannot serve the world and God at the same time. No, it doesn't happen. You cannot mix an oil and water. No, you cannot mix.
Amen.
So if God be God,
Amen.
Let him be served.
Amen.
If Baal be God,
Amen.
Then serve him. But he said, as for me,
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
As for me,
Amen.
In my house,
Amen.
We shall serve the Lord.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
Fellowship.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Fellowship is based upon agreement. No, the dove and the crow has got nothing to agree upon.
Hence
they cannot be friends.
Amen.
And fellowship is a love affair.
Amen.
Praise the name of
our
Lord. Let's take a quotation from the Message. Fellowship through the blood. Preach 1960. Amen.
Amen.
I am still quoting the prophet.
Amen.
Because I believe he's still relevant.
Yes.
Amen. He's the only man that I'm still quoting.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Remember when he preaches the message. What is the name of the message? Spiritual food in due season. He said the church actually represents Elijah. When there was drought in the land in Israel, because of sin, God said to Elijah, there is a place where I want you to be. Because the righteous, hallelujah, cannot be judged with the unrighteous. Go by the river chase. God chose a place for him to feed him where? To feed him there. Now in our day, God has given us the message of the hour that we should be fed. Where? Here. Glory be to God. The Bible says in the last days there will be famine.
Amen.
Amen. That is what we see.
Amen.
You go to the churches,
Amen.
You go to the denomination, it's just hunger.
Amen.
People are dying.
Amen.
The ministers does not know what to preach anymore. Amen. The only thing they preach is give. And they busy in reaching themselves. But here, remember where God said to Elijah, there will I feed thee.
There
God's chosen place for Elijah to be sustained. Elijah, go there. And God, you know, is a miraculous
God.
Amen.
Amen.
Takes the crow again to bring
the
sandwich.
every day. You know this bed? I don't know how God worked this. I don't know how God chose to use it. But God gave Elijah the servant the
bread
to come and feed him. Bring breakfast. Bring supper. Hallelujah. My God, we're serving the same God.
Amen.
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 Glory to God. Amen. So we're eating from the right pot.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The pot that was cooked from heaven. Spiritual manna. Spiritual food in due season. The denominations cannot accept this. The prophet of God saying this food is too heavy for them. They cannot digest this food. It's for a special class of people.
Amen.
I'm talking too much today.
Amen.
I'm blessed. I'm happy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. You know this message makes me crazy.
Yeah.
You know this message. You know when you don't visit this message. When you don't visit this message. But when you live in
my
God.
Amen.
And the person that is staying in the message.
Amen.
They can be in the same assembly.
But
they are different. Their language is different. Their conduct is different. Their behavior is different. Because somebody is staying in it. And somebody is visiting.
Amen.
So let's stay in it. Now he's saying, he's saying, now we find out that fellowship is based upon agreement. He's saying it has to be that way. Because fellowship is something that we like to do. Come together. It's just like a young man and a young woman meeting each other. And they love one another. And they just can't keep out of one another's side. Now we know, brethren, how we felt. And sisters, how you felt when you met your husband.
Amen.
Amen. There's a fellowship. Every night. You just can't wait for the time for your date. Not today's dates. Today's dates are unholy. You know, marriage is no longer respected the way it should be. Are people, they go to honeymoon before marriage? It was never so. It was not so from the beginning. No! It doesn't work that way. There is steps to be followed.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now the devil has entered in. Turning things around. Turning things around. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So you want, he says, you every night you just can't wait for the time for your date. You want to take her somewhere to get something to eat. And you can sit and talk. And watch her. It's a fellowship. Now, before that can be fellowship, it has to be based upon agreement. These two has to agree. Then there will be a fellowship. See, upon an agreement, and that's just as true as it can be.
Amen.
He says what makes us want to fellowship is because it's something in us that God, it's something in us that requires that requires it.
Sorry.
Now the fellowship is a love affair.
There
cannot be a fellowship between the two if there is no love. Praise the name of the Lord. So that is the fellowship. Now, God, when he created a man, in the beginning, he created a man for a fellowship. Because God wants to fellowship with somebody. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God created a man to fellowship with him. The reason you are created, the reason that we are here,
Amen.
Is because God wants to fellowship with us. He's saying, God longs for fellowship. He yearns. He wants people to speak with him and to talk with him. Praise the name of God. He said, you might sing too much. You might preach too much. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But there's one thing you will never be able to overdo.
And
that's prayer.
I
would that men pray everywhere. You will never be able to have too much fellowship with God.
And
God longs for his creature
who
he has created in his image to have fellowship with him. Hallelujah. Praise the name of God. God wants us to fellowship with him because God loves fellowship.
When
God created a man, he created him to fellowship with him. Amen.
Amen.
When we go back in the Garden of Eden, because it's where everything
starts.
God created Adam. And Adam was lonely. He was by himself. And God, the first operator, took Adam and put him on the operation table. Hallelujah. And put a rib. Hallelujah. One rib. The Almighty God removed from this man. Today. I don't know what's happening. Some is three ribs that have been removed. Some is four. They say it depends on the money that you have. They say if you can afford to take care of them, then you can help them. The number is not a problem. But it was not so from the beginning. God took Adam and placed him on the table of operation. It was one rib.
Yeah.
Whatever that is happening today, we must look back and see if it happened there. If it's not corresponding with what happened then, we don't take it. God does not change. He's the same God. Praise the name of the Lord. He gave him Eve. And he said, she is the bone of my bone. He did not say they are bone of my bone. No, sir. He said she is the bone of my bone. Hallelujah.
Adam.
Hallelujah. Started to have a fellowship with Eve. Showing Eve around. Showing Eve his kingdom. Hallelujah. The Son of God with the daughter of God. In perfect harmony. And the prophet says, you know, this prophet is a dangerous prophet. You know, he can tell you certain things that you never thought about.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
He said one day, Peter, James, and John came to him, to Jesus Christ. Jesus was sitting on the Mount of Olives. He said, it was on a Tuesday. And when they came to
Jesus,
it was around 11 o'clock. How did this man pick these things up? Hallelujah! God could unveil. God will show him things that we could not see. He was not an ordinary man. He was a God man. Hallelujah! I'm not saying let's worship the man. No. He said let my mistakes, because he was a man. Be a stepping stone. So he would see things. He would see beyond. One child died. And the parents were worried. And they came to Brother
Branham.
Hey, our son is gone. Brother Branham. He said, I will look for him. And he came back.
Abuwa
said, your son is in a better place. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that man was a different man. He was fully anointed by God.
Amen.
That is why God will say to him, won't you like to take a stroll?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God himself.
Yes.
Remember, God is a holy God. Now imagine God leaving his throne. Coming down on the mother earth to take a stroll with his son. My God.
Amen.
My God.
Amen.
Don't worry.
Amen.
We are heading the same day.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, God will come down
in
the cool of the evening.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then Adam and Eve,
Adam and Eva,
will start to fellowship with God.
Amen.
Because there was love. There was agreement. So God was able to come and have fellowship with
them.
And it was so good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God would ask them, how was their day?
Amen.
And Adam would say, Father, today I moved that mountain from this side to another side.
Amen.
And I moved that river. You remember that river?
Amen.
I shifted it and put it on the other side.
Amen.
And God will say, amen.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
What a fellowship they had.
Amen.
What an agreement they had.
Amen.
What a love they had.
Amen.
Brother Dad was watching all
time.
Amen. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
The devil was watching all the time. Praise the name. And the devil did not like it. That's why when you pray, he gets furious. When you fellowship with your brothers, he doesn't like it. He hates it. When you fast and pray, he hates it. That is why he makes it hard that we should pray, that we should fast.
Amen.
You know, when you are not fasting, you can spend almost the whole day without food.
Yeah.
The day you declare is, I'm getting into fasting. That is why I don't fast at home. And you will end up preparing breakfast.
Amen.
Amen. So rather go out somewhere and pray and fast there. Even if you feel that it's empty, there is nothing to
do.
Amen.
Now some they say, no, we fast with snacks. We have some Simba chips in here.
Simba yamu.
We are fasting. It doesn't work. That is not fasting, it's dieting. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. So the devil hates it. When the children of God are doing God the same, when the children of God praise, the devil doesn't like it. When the children
children of God praise. The devil doesn't want
it.
You must come here Wednesday, Tuesday prayer night. Tuesday night. Come here Tuesday night. They don't do it deliberately. They allow the devil to keep them busy. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
So in the Garden of Eden,
now what you imagine?
When Adam was doing, administrating everything in
Adam,
the garden, the devil was watching. And he was not happy. And he knew that he could do Adam nothing. Amen. He had to come with a plan.
Amen.
And he started to research. He checked the family structure of Adam. And he checked. And he saw a breakthrough. The woman.
Amen.
Amen. You know, he came with the gospel. You know the devil is a smart preacher. The devil knows the word. The prophet says he doesn't quote the word. He quotes it.
Amen.
So he came with a quoted word. And when she looked at it, she loved it. But she did not wait for the husband to come back. Amen.
Amen.
That is why I often say, if a brother comes to your house, sister, during the day, and the father of the house is not there, don't open the door. Open the door, but don't open the
butler.
It doesn't matter who that man is. Just open the door. Not even, don't open even fully. Open it a little bit. Shalom, sister.
Shalom, morning.
Shalom, brother.
Shalom, brother.
And sister said, the brother is not here. Come later.
Amen.
He's home 6 o'clock.
What man, you are 6.
God bless you.
God bless you.
Brother, the devil say you are rude. But you don't want trouble.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
We've heard a lot of stories.
Yes.
And we don't want them.
Amen.
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 We don't want them.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We don't want them.
Amen.
We've had enough of them.
Amen.
Shut the door.
Yes.
Shut the door.
Amen.
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 Not even a cup of tea.
Yes.
Brother Branham says,
brother Branham,
when I get to that house, and the brother is not at home, so I go and sit in my car, outside, and wait for the brother.
Yes.
I can't sit in the house.
Wow.
Now who are you and me?
Yes.
Brother, so you're sitting on your sofa,
brother.
Yes. When you are not there. No, who doesn't wear that? Yes. This brother, whoever, shut the door.
Amen.
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 Because we've seen what happened in the garden. It comes a long way this year. And we don't want it here. Praise the name of
Amen.
God.
Amen.
So she didn't wait for Adam.
So I said to Adam,
she listened.
Yes.
And the preacher preached. And she was convinced. And this preacher is preaching better than my husband. She listened. She listened. And she acted. Amen.
Amen.
Where the trouble started.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. That is why I'm saying, shut the door.
Amen.
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 I'm saying it again. It doesn't matter who he is.
Yes.
Whether he's a bishop.
Yeah.
Whether
he's a bishop.
If he's not with his wife.
Yeah.
If he's alone.
Yeah.
Shut the door.
Yeah.
If he's a deacon, saying.
Hallelujah.
We're living in the last days.
Yeah.
We have the quotation here.
Yeah.
Oh, the tactics that the devil has used. He has brought them all together. So we don't want troubles. Amen. We want to go to the millennium. We want to go to the millennium. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
She listening. Amen.
Amen.
Now when Adam came, she gave Adam the teaching of the serpent.
Yes, yeah, yeah, no.
She was deceived. But Adam was not deceived. When Adam embraced that doctrine of the serpent, he knew what he was doing.
Yes.
She compromised with his wife.
Yeah.
She knew very well that God has said, the day you eat thereof, you will surely die.
Yes.
He was prepared to surely die because of his wife. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. After taking the doctrine from the pit of hell, for the first time, they recognize their nakedness. Amen.
Amen.
Now they say it was apple. And they say it's apricot. Brother Branham says it's a sexual sin.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Glory be to God.
Amen.
And God has to keep his way.
Amen.
Remember, God was coming every evening.
Amen.
In the cool of the day.
Amen.
To have a fellowship with them.
Amen.
But that day, when he came down, Adam was nowhere to be found. His son was out of his position. His daughter was out of her position.
Amen.
God is turning now, starting to look. Because God loves fellowship. And now God has come down for a fellowship as usual. But that afternoon, the fellowship was broken. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The fellowship line was cut off.
Amen.
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 No sin is very dangerous.
Yes.
It breaks families.
It
breaks churches.
Yes.
It breaks individuals.
Yes.
And it nearly broke heaven.
Yes.
But God could not stand
it. Yes.
He said, not here.
Yes.
Kick them out.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Yes.
Now Adam, after he recognized his nakedness, he tried a religion, a fig leaf religion. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It could not work.
Yeah.
Don't you be surprised when you see churches with uniforms.
Yeah.
It originates from the Garden of Eden.
Yeah.
Trying to cover their sins with fig leaves. Today, they are trying to cover their sins with church uniforms.
Amen.
They are hiding themselves in churches. Adam was hiding himself in the bushes. But today they are hiding themselves in churches. Because in churches, sin is no longer rebuked.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Then God began to call. Adam, Adam,
Adam, Adam,
where Adam? God was longing for that fellowship.
Amen.
Amen. Adam, Adam, where Adam?
Adam, Adam, okay.
Sin has already taken over.
Yeah.
Now, when God finds Adam, Adam says, I'm naked. God says to Adam, who told you that you're naked? Who told you that you're naked? Did you eat from where I told you not to eat? Amen.
Amen.
It was a lie.
Yeah.
When the prophet preached the message, why?
He says
that is what God is asking.
Yes.
And on that day of the judgment, you'll find the same thing.
Yes.
Why? So whatever we do, let's make sure that it's not questionable to God. Because the why of God, the why of God is a dangerous why. Why did you do it?
We did it in heaven.
Who told you to do it?
Hallelujah.
I don't want to be there.
Amen.
Somebody help me, God.
Amen.
Now, God of mercy,
yeah.
God of love,
yeah.
He could not sit back. He has to make a plan. Because his son was out of his position.
Amen.
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 Let me tell you something beautiful about fellowship. This is the secret of the prophet. It is a secret that I was not aware of until when God gave me the inspiration about this message. He's saying, many people has watched my life in the healing campaigns. How would things take place? And the prophetic gift. And so forth. Just like to tell you how that is done.
Mm-hmm.
Son, I just want to tell you how it's done.
He
just wants to tell you how did he get it right. Praise the name of the Lord. The prophet of God is giving us a secret.
Yeah.
How he gets things right. In the human campaigns. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
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 This man did not go to get the marine power, the marine spirit. No. He's saying, I want to give you the secret.
Amen.
I want to tell you how it's done.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Many men today,
yes.
They go somewhere.
Yes.
To get power. And they tell you that that power, in order for you to maintain it, every month you must sleep with the virgin,
yeah.
To maintain the power.
Yeah.
Believe us, these things are real and everywhere. That is why I'm preaching about them. Because it's not a secret. Amen. Amen. So now we're going to hear how the prophet got it right. Because the prophet got it right. Without the marine spirit. Hallelujah. Without the powers from Nigeria. Hallelujah. He got it right through the power of the Almighty God. Well, let's hear what he
said.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's done through fellowship,
yes. Kopane, sure.
With
Amen.
Jesus Christ.
Amen. Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That is that.
Amen.
You want the power?
We have a
fellowship.
Kopane, Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Yes.
You don't have to go anywhere. Right in your bedroom. Go down on your knees. Have a fellowship with Jesus.
Amen.
And you will see this happening. Amen.
Amen.
He's saying it's done through fellowship with Jesus. He's saying no other way.
Yes.
No other plan. No trick. No trick to it.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Just simply plain fellowship.
Amen.
Taking God at his word.
Amen.
What he said was the truth.
Yeah.
Believing it.
Yeah.
And that settles it.
So
then talk to him. Love him.
Amen.
Thank him for it.
And that's
it.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's it. In the campaigns, people will get healed.
Yes.
Because that does it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The campaigns. The prophetic will happen and take place. Because that. That's it. Fellowship with Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. So you see how simple it is. So do you have to spend thousands of rands? Take a flight, risk your life to go and collect demons from another country and bring those demons in this country, in your house, in your family, in the church of God. It doesn't work. It doesn't work. There is a way. And the prophet of God has shown us the way. Praise the name.
Amen.
Amen.
Is the time still allowing me?
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
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 So that fellowship was broken down.
Yo,
because the devil hates fellowship.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hence you see now Adam. And Eve was in a hopeless case situation without God, without the protection they had, without the fellowship. You were naked.
Yeah.
The devil can do anything about you. Anytime. Amen. He can do anything about your children. He can do anything about your wife, about you. Because you were naked. You don't have a protection. You don't have a fellowship with God. And you are a powerless Christian.
Hallelujah.
A powerless Christian is a Christian that does not have fellowship with God. That kind of a Christian, the devil is not even afraid. He can come anytime in your house.
Yeah.
And switch the TV on.
I like the TV.
There's no more altar.
I was on the altar.
Where the family comes together to pray. Because the family is a weak. It's a weak family. The altar now has been taken over by TV. Amen.
Amen.
Nowadays it's even worse. Cell phones.
The phone
has taken the time of prayer. Cell phones.
The phone
has taken the time of fellowship.
Amen.
Amen. Young and old are glued to the cell phones. And when you look what they are doing in the cell phones, it's pornography.
Amen.
Amen.
I told you. The prophet has said all the tricks, all the schemes that the devil has ever used before, he has brought them together. Cell phone is evil. Smartphone is taking people to hell. It's worse than TV.
Amen.
It's worse than TV.
Amen.
Because the things that you get in there,
don't
more. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They take you direct to hell.
Amen.
Young boy watching pornography on the cell phone. On the cell phone.
Amen.
And you are the one.
When a
parent that bought the thing.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
On top of that, you put the data on. And now this son, this girl, is watching the adults naked, doing that which is uncommon.
Sure.
That is exactly what is happening. Watch your cell phones. Cell phone is taking men and women. Boys and girls. To hell.
God help us.
Today you get this free Wi-Fi. You find the young and old around the school.
With their cell phones.
They are not studying. They are not reading the Bible in the same form. No. They're in another dimension of hell. Watching the nakedness of people. How do you enjoy to watch naked people as a child of the living God? If you are doing that, you better repent. And if you don't repent, you will go to hell, young lady. You will go to hell, young lady.
Amen.
Amen.
We are living in the last days. We are living in the last days. The Bible says the devil in Revelation 12, verse 12.
Can we read it?
Pornography has taken over. We need to pray for our young people.
Amen.
Because we are losing them.
Amen.
Verse 12 says, therefore rejoice ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea. For the devil is come down unto you, having great wrath, because he knoweth that he hath but a short time.
Tabari le nama godimo le ba ba rile go bona ba madima bekile na ba ba rile go le fasile le watle go ba le diabolo o theoetse go lena a duka bogale ka kudu o tsiba ge a sa tsheletswe ke le bakanya na fela.
So the devil is no longer playing games.
So Satan ga a sa le mo papadi.
Amen. I believe those who gonna survive this
is
those who are using those phones.
You
know those ones? It's just SMS. And phone hello. Amen. Now the devil has made it even worse. Because data is expensive. You go to these institutions. You find free
Wi-Fi.
Because the devil wants you in his territory. The devil wants to go with you to hell. The devil doesn't want you in the millennium.
Amen.
Amen.
We better be careful of our phones. God help us with these phones. You know the devil has been making a lot of plans. But when coming to this one, he got a victory. Young and old the same.
To hell.
Amen.
Amen.
God help us.
Would you mind to say?
We cannot be in fellowship with God when we are busy with these things. God hates sin. That is why God kicked sin out of heaven. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So now the devil has come down with a wrath. Yes. He came with a smartphone. He came with the data. And free Wi-Fi. And handed everything to the people. Believer and non-believer the same. Say, here is hell. Put hell in your pocket. Amen. That is what the devil has done. And he has succeeded. Brother is saying many people are serving the devil, thinking that they are serving God. Joshua said, hallelujah, choose ye. If God be God, serve him.
Thank you,
and the only way, hallelujah,
amen,
to overcome the devil is to stay in fellowship with God. Stay in fellowship with God. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Then Adam and Eve were imperfect fellowship with God. They did not have any trouble.
Amen.
Let's go to the message of fellowship.
Amen.
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 Yeah.
Preach 1955.
He's saying, now a man was born to have fellowship
motho o belegetswe a be le kopanelo.
Man in the beginning,
motho o mathomong.
Back in the garden of Eden,
ko tshimo ya Eden.
He had a wonderful fellowship,
o bana le kopanelo e botse.
God come down and fellowship with his company,
modimo a theoa kopana le batho ba
gagwe. Men and women every evening,
banna monna le mosadi mantsiwa mangwe.
In the cool of evening,
ka nako ya mantsiwa e le dikela.
In the cool of the evening,
mantsiwa e le dikela.
God would come down under the great palm tree,
modimota thabela mo fase ga se tlhabise segolo sa mo
palema. Under the palm tree perhaps,
motlhomo ka fase ga se tlhabisa mo palema.
That is why I'm saying brother
Brennan. Na go le brother Brennan mo
ne. This man,
hey. You know,
he could see where our eyes can
bona mo matlhana sa bone.
My God.
Amen.
Now listen to what he's saying.
Now you go on go remfa.
I've got this belief.
Okay,
that when the prophet of God preaches, he would preach about something that he sees.
Yes.
Amen.
Because the way he would explain it, the way he would tell you certain things that you did not see, it is really amazing. Amen.
Amen.
So I believe when he was preaching, he was preaching under a vision,
yes.
Under the inspiration of the power of God.
Amen.
Amen. That's what I believe.
Amen.
Because how could he get these certain things?
Amen.
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 Under this great palm tree,
this
great secret light,
it
was shining down upon Adam and Eve in that great cathedral in the open.
Amen.
My God.
Amen.
My God. Fellowship with God. Now, he had nothing to worry about as long as they were fellowshipping.
Yeah.
He said, I love to fellowship with men. I like to go out and talk with people who love the Lord and have fellowship with them. Because we see the same thing. Our motives are the same.
Wow.
Our ideals are the same. I like to talk with people on the
dot dot dot.
Right?
Alright.
You hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I've got a friend sitting right here. Down here, like to hunt and fish. Many times we have a lot of fellowship together.
Mm.
Just sitting around talking on those things. Because we like those things.
Yeah.
But he's saying, but the greatest fellowship that any man ever had was when he had a fellowship with God.
Yeah.
When God had gave himself open,
yeah,
to a man to fellowship back and forth with the Creator and the Creator and his creature. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now listen to this. When God was fellowshipping with Adam in the Garden of Eden, Adam had nothing to worry about.
Praise
the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. There was nothing to worry about.
Amen.
Because he had a perfect fellowship with his God. Amen.
Amen.
He's saying everything was on the smooth.
Yeah.
Running right. He didn't have to worry about his clothes.
Yeah.
Today you find people don't want to come to church because they don't have new clothes. Because they don't have better clothes. But Adam did not worry about the clothes. He didn't have to worry about what I'm going to eat.
Yeah.
My Lord, the fellowship is there.
Hey,
Fellowship is dangerous.
Fellowship is dangerous. Praise the name of the Lord. He didn't have to worry about sickness. He didn't have to worry about death. No sorrow. He knew nothing about that. Just the freedom like a child. He had the Heavenly Father who watched over him and fellowship with him daily. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Wouldn't it be marvelous if we could go back like that again?
Amen.
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 Now it was broken. Sin broke it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now God had to do something. Because the lamb that God has slain in the garden. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It was an animal. And the animal life.
Could
not come back to be upon a human being. Adam's sins were forgiven. But
Adam,
I mean his sins, were covered. Because the blood of animals has got no power to take away the sin. But the blood of
Jesus
has got power to take away the sin.
Amen.
Is the time still allowing?
Amen.
Amen.
Let's go.
Amen.
The book of Hebrews.
Amen.
Let's go to the book of Hebrews.
Amen.
We're talking about fellowshipping with God.
Amen.
We are not concerned about the time.
Amen.
It's a holy day.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let the world have their time.
Amen.
Drink their beer.
Amen.
We are fellowshipping with God.
Amen.
We are under the fellowship with God.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
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 Are you in the book of Hebrews?
Amen.
Hebrews chapter 13.
Over Hebrews 13.
Glory.
Shumani Vangeli. Satani Ashani. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Yeah. I take verse 12.
You got verse 12.
It says,
Irmore.
Wherefore Jesus also, that he might save his own blood,
yes,
suffered without the gate.
He said, Jesus, I did the Mola at Satra, the Savaka Maria Arabe, Bamola di Quentin Rahoro.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us go, therefore, unto him without the camp, bearing his reproach.
Toana Aripirim.
Let's go to verse 20.
I go verse 20.
Now the God of peace that brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant.
Amen.
Amen. Hebrews 10.
By Hebrews 10.
Let your finger be there where we just read Hebrews
13.
The Bible says, verse 4.
Bible Elmore, verse 4.
For it is not possible that the blood of bulls and of goats should take away sin.
Tenfold, yes. It's not much.
Amen.
Right.
Now, Hebrews 9, verse 22.
Hebrews 9, 22. Yeah.
Some of us don't read the Bible.
Baba Marana read the Bible.
So today we're reading this
Bible.
Amen.
This Bible is not just to display at home. It's to be read, this Bible. It's to help a Christian to be a Christian. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. You have to
read it. Amen.
Hebrews 9:22.
9:22.
It says,
Irmo.
And almost all things I by the law, purged with blood,
And without the shedding of blood is no remission.
Amen.
Amen. Verse 4 says of chapter 10.
Verse 4 of chapter
10. The blood of bulls and goats should not take away sins.
Amen.
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 This blood
Maria
could not take away the sin of
Adam.
In the Old Testament, when they sacrificed unto the Lord, the blood of bulls, hallelujah, and goats, could not take away or patch their sins. Hence, after they made those sacrifices, they went out with the same desire in their hearts. But the blood of Jesus, hallelujah, the blood of Jesus is the only blood God has got power.
Hallelujah.
The blood of Jesus has got power to remit, to take away all sins. Oh, glory be to God. Through the shedding of the blood, God brought men into the fellowship with himself. Without the shedding of the blood of Jesus, there is no reconciliation. Hallelujah. There is no covenant. When the covenant is made, the blood has to be shed.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
In every covenant, the blood has to be shed. In marriage covenant, there is blood. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That has to be shed. That is why, young lady, young woman, you must live clean before God. Because whenever you engage into sexual activity outside of marriage, you've made a covenant. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
It's a covenant. And this covenant is not to be broken. That is why it gives us a shame,
or
breaks our hearts, to find a young lady growing under the message of the hour, when the day of vows are made, it gets discovered. Hallelujah. That the virginity has been broken. It is not supposed to be like that. That is not God's way. That's not God's doing. Yes, will put it at the I feel like speaking in tongues.
Amen.
In order to present this thing in a right way.
Amen.
You know, this gospel is dripping with blood.
Amen.
We are what we are today.
Amen.
Because the blood was shed.
Amen.
We are Christians today.
Amen.
Because of the blood.
Yes,
you must handle this gospel.
Amen.
With dignity.
Amen.
With respect. Because it deserves to be respected.
Amen.
Amen.
It's dripping with blood. Men of God were slain because of this gospel. It's dripping with blood. Refuse to compromise with this gospel. Hallelujah. My God of mercy. The covenant. God respects it. That is why, I don't know how, but it happened to be like that. That even in the marriage, there has to be blood.
Yes.
You You hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
You hear what I'm saying?
Young
sisters. And you young brothers. You hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
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 Let us serve God. Let us handle His word with respect.
Amen.
With dignity.
Amen.
Amen. That it deserves.
This is vanity.
This is life eternal.
Hallelujah.
That is why the devil hates this.
Amen.
This is God.
Amen.
This is the Almighty that written for us. Let us respect God.
Amen.
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 Time is still allowing me.
Now, because I'm
Amen.
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 Glory to God.
Amen.
So when the blood was shed,
Amen.
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 It was the blood of the covenant. The precious blood. It was not a Jewish blood. Amen.
Amen.
The blood of Jesus has got no connection with Jews. It is the blood of God Himself. That is why it is the only blood that can take away sin. Are the blood.
You
cannot take away sin.
Amen.
Only the blood.
Amen.
The blood of God.
Amen.
You cannot take away your sin.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Hence we must not forget.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What He has done for us.
Yeah.
At Calvary.
Amen.
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 He was not a sinner.
Amen.
But He became a sinner.
Amen.
Because of you.
Amen.
We must thank God day and night.
Amen.
For the shedding of the blood.
Amen.
Glory.
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
Yeah. Glory to
you. Amen.
So the blood. Remember sin. Brought a division. Segregation. Separation. Between God and man. And now the blood. And not only the blood, but the blood of Jesus Christ. The only blood.
Yes.
The only blood. Yes. That brought us back.
Yes.
That brought men back into the fellowship.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Back into the fellowship with God.
Is
the innocent. Dying for the guilty.
Yes.
The Bible says when you are born. When you are born,
no,
you are born in sin already.
Yeah.
Because you took from your father Adam.
Yeah.
We took from our father Adam.
Yeah.
When Adam was kicked out of the Garden of Eden,
yeah.
We were also kicked out.
Yeah.
Because we were in our father Adam.
Yeah.
Amen. So when Adam was blessed,
yeah.
We were also blessed.
Yeah.
And when Adam was kicked out,
yeah.
We were also kicked out.
Yeah.
Because we were born in sin,
yeah.
Shaping iniquity,
yeah.
Coming to the world speaking
like
praise
yeah.
The name of the Lord,
amen.
Glory, hallelujah,
amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So Adam could now fellowship with God.
Mm.
But his sins were still there.
Mm.
Because he was covered with the blood of the Lamb. Animal blood.
Right.
But when you come to a Christian today, when Jesus, when he died,
wow.
Praise the name
of
God. That day when that man died.
Mm.
That was a day never to forget.
Yes.
Because before that day, we wouldn't be sitting here.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible says, he shed his blood.
Mm-hmm.
And on the cross, he said it is finished. Amen. What is finished?
Things is
the separation between
yeah.
man and God
Amen.
Is coming to an end.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What was Jesus dying at Calvary? He was standing in the gap, taking the sinner by hand and taking God by hand. And Jesus, this main man, brought us together into fellowship with God. Without Jesus, we cannot be restored to fellowship. Jesus had to die.
Amen.
My Lord, His Spirit went back to God. His soul went and preached. His body was left in the tomb. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
He resurrected on the third day.
Amen.
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 Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And he said to his disciples, tarry ye in Jerusalem.
Amen.
Wait for me there.
Amen.
Praise the name of God. They waited.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And they waited.
Amen.
And they waited.
Amen.
The 120.
Amen.
They were fellowshipping.
Amen.
And in their fellowship,
Amen.
There was a time
Amen.
Where there was disagreement.
Amen.
Some said, but I feel something.
Amen.
Some said, I feel the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Peter said, let's wait.
Amen.
They said, wait.
Wow,
upon the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible says on the day of
Pentecost.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There was a mighty rushing wind. What was happening that day?
Yeah.
That Spirit of God came upon them.
Amen.
The Bible says there was tongues of fire upon them.
Amen.
The pillar of fire
Amen.
Divided itself.
Amen.
And spread itself among them. And there was a perfect fellowship. My God, when they were coming down the upper room, when they went up, they were cowards. They went up there because they were fearful. But praise God, when the Holy Ghost came down on that day of Pentecost, my Lord, they came filled with the Spirit of God. And now they were bold. They're fearful. After received the Holy Ghost, fear was cast out of their heart. Praise the name of the Lord. And they went out. Hallelujah, staggering. Under the power of the Holy Ghost. Under the power of the resurrection power. My God.
Amen.
They were filled with the Holy Ghost. They were filled with the resurrection power. My God, these men and women, they were on fire for God. And when they went to Jerusalem, when they went down, my God, the people said, these are drunk. Peter said, these are not drunk. These are filled. This is Joel chapter 2 in action. Remember, when they were in fellowship with God, the dead was raised.
Yeah.
Now, when God was fellowshipping with Adam in the Garden of Eden, Adam had nothing to worry about. Everything was smooth, running right. He didn't have to worry about his clothes. He didn't have to worry about something to eat. He didn't have to worry about sickness. He didn't have to worry about death and so on. So when the 120 were coming down, they did not worry about all these things. They were like Adam. They had power. My God.
Amen.
Because they were now
in
perfect
fellowship
with God. They were now into the Holy of Holies. When the Shekinah glory of God.
Amen.
Amen. My God.
Amen.
What are we hearing here?
Hey.
We thank God for this message.
Amen.
They were in the Shekinah glory.
Hey.
Listen, in the message, Revelations chapter 4. He says, what is the Shekinah glory? My God.
Amen.
These men were these men and women. Yeah, it's not closing the our sisters. They've got the right to enter into the Holy of
Holies.
Because it used to be the high priest once a year. But when Jesus died, he said it is finished. The captain in the temple was torn apart from top to bottom. It was God tearing it.
Amen.
He's saying now it was death to enter in.
Wow.
Now I'm opening a way. And now it's death not to enter in.
Yeah.
No, you must enter in.
Amen.
Into the Shekinah glory. And get eternal life in there. And have the perfect fellowship in there. Why? In the Holy of Holies. In the Shekinah glory. God is where the fellowship is restored.
Amen.
In there. In there. In there, there is life.
Amen.
Aaron.
Aaroni.
One day,
yeah.
He forgot his stuff.
Hey.
The next time when they went in, meaning that it was the following year, it bloomed already.
But
when they speak for him,
I'm
sure they had some fruits.
Why?
It was dead. But because it was brought into the presence of God, there is no death. There is life. That is why the Bible says, the scripture we read of 1 John, God is light. God is light.
Amen.
So when you get into that Shekinah glory,
amen,
then you begin to be alive.
Amen.
Is time still allowing?
Amen.
Amen. Alright.
Right.
Now, what is the Shekinah glory? Is God's presence.
Amen.
When a man walks or a woman
is
reflecting the Shekinah glory. If you've been in there, he doesn't go into gambling dance and carrying on and go out here and deny the word. No matter what the people say, he's got his heart set on one thing, God.
Amen.
And if he truly is called of God, then Jesus Christ reflects himself through him with the Shekinah glory.
Amen.
Doing the same things he did back there. Manifesting the same gospel. Preaching the same word.
Amen.
So if you've been under the Shekinah glory, you cannot preach any other thing. But the pure word of God. When you hear a man preaching something else, you must know he's never been under the Shekinah. My God.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. It's the Shekinah glory.
It's
the Holy of Holies.
Amen.
I'm closing with this one. You all have heard me saying that people said, the devil made me do this. No. The devil didn't do it. You. Every little thing. The devil made me. The prophet says, no. It's you.
Who
decided to do it?
Why not get
you
no idea?
Amen.
You sin willfully. You commit adultery and fornication willfully. And say the devil made me do it. No, you. wasn't sealed in.
When
you are sealed in, he is sealed out.
Now
you went to him.
Glory.
Siyamsulela
uSathane.
Ngikubula kaSathane ula. Enthina siyaya kuye.
Ushethe kamuna.
You say you went to him.
Wena ukulela kaSathane.
Hey. He couldn't get into you.
Ubasa abakasikhulotsa namuwe.
Because the only way to get into you.
Ngatsela ithi yara khulotsa namuwe.
It's come through the same process.
Kur atleka tsela yetfana.
What you have.
Ye wena udinga yona.
You would have to be saved.
Wena ndara ukuzinga aphuluswe.
You would have to be sanctified.
I quake
and be filled with the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
But just imagine that.
Saved.
Sanctified.
Hey.
Filled with the Holy Ghost. My God. Then. When he's like that, he will be your brother. He will be your brother. Amen. To get to where you are, if at all you are in the Shekinah glory. Amen. Remember when the priest enters. From the outer camp, outer court, into the holy court, into the holy of holies. When he entered in there, he had to enter dressed the right way, anointed the right way, and changed. Because in there, there is God.
Yeah.
And he must not enter in like that. He must also have the blood.
Amen.
My God, you see, the blood is getting everywhere.
Yeah.
The blood is very important.
Amen.
That is why the Bible says, don't eat that meat with the blood inside.
Yeah.
When Israel was leaving Egypt, God said to them, don't even cook it. Make a bright face. And celebrate before the
Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
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 So when you enter in there, and he's not anointed right, and he's without the blood, he will die.
Amen.
Now the reason they were putting a rope on him because many died in there. So when there's no movement and there must be a bell
ticking
to tell that I'm still alive. And if there's no movement, there's no clicking, he's dead. That is how it is with other churches. The word is preached, no movement. Not they are dead. God will pull them. He pull them and throw them in hell. He will be your brother. So you see. He didn't do it. No. You just went to the borderline and come back lusting for the things of the world. You never went all the way over into Canaan. You see, across Jordan to death to self. Death to self. Amen.
Amen.
Let us stand.
Amen.
Sorry, Pastor. I preached too long today.
Amen.
But I tell you why. Because many times I preach here on Tuesdays night. And I have to cut my messages. Because I'm concerned that people go to work tomorrow. But today I bless the Lord. They called me during the day.
Amen.
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 Now if it's during the day, how we preach it.
Amen.
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 Let us bow our heads. Precious Lord, Heavenly Father, thank you very much. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we say thank you for thy word. Lord, we appreciate the message of the hour. I pray that thou, Lord, my God, will please help us that we should live a life that is in line with this message.
Amen.
Help us to walk right. Help us to respect your word. Please help us, Lord God, to take thee at thy word and to be in constant fellowship with thee. May you bless us. May you bless this assembly. May you bless the leadership, O God. May you please bless, Lord God, the laity as a whole, the young and the old. Father, I pray for them that thou will bless them, O God. May there be none of them that will be left behind. May there be none of them who will miss the millennium. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, as I present them to thee, O God, I pray a special blessing upon each and every one of us, O God. In the name of Jesus Christ, we say thank you for your word, O God. May you bless us now as we are about to part, O God, from one another. May your grace, may your spirit be with us.
Yes.
In the name of our Lord Jesus, we say thank you, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you, saints.
Amen. Amen. Amen.